In this video, we will show you how to perform left bundle branch area pacing using a stylet-driven lead. In a previous video, we have shown you how to perform LBBAP with the more popular 3830 lead by Medtronic, which is a lumenless lead with a fixed helix. We are now using the Biotronic His guiding catheter and the standard Solia S60 lead with extendable helix. In contrary to the 3830 lead with fixed helix, in leads with extendable helix, good preparation is essential. Preparation may be either performed on the preparation table or, like in this video, within the guiding catheter. The helix needs to be extended in order to enable transseptal progression. Using the standard clip-on tool, 10 to 15 turns are applied in order to extend the helix. Then the green stylet rotation tool is used to perform 10 additional turns in order to prevent helix unwinding during septal perforation. One of the major advantages of using a stylet-driven lead is that ECG and impedance measurements may be performed continuously throughout the septal perforation process. This patient, previously implanted with a dual chamber ICD, needed resynchronization therapy because of permanent RV pacing. We can see that the guiding catheter is positioned against the septum in perpendicular fashion in LAO view. While progressing through the septum, we need to make sure that the green stylet tool remains fixed and the stylet stable. On fluoroscopy, we can see the lead advancing through the interventricular septum. Impedance values may be monitored to guide this process, as declining trend signifies reaching the LVN cardial zone. The 12-lead ECG before onset of screwing shows a W pattern in lead 1, a white QRS with fragmentation of R-wave in V6. Using EP software may be helpful, where the left part of the screen shows a triggered slow display of the QRS. During screwing, we can see the emerging R' wave in V1. We can see the R wave in V5 becomes monophasic with a fast upslope. This is a patient with advanced conduction disease, as there is a long interval between the pacing interval and the onset of the QRS wave. But with the QRS narrowing from around 200 milliseconds to under 120 milliseconds, the final result is very satisfactory.